On the day of recording, there was a fire outside Bangunan Yin. Not to worry. No pastors were hurt in the process of this recording.
Sorry. Do you smell that? Like, it smells like match, like, but... the seat too hot. Hello, welcome to SIBKL Hot Seat, our limited series where we have conversation with our current senior pastors and our incoming senior pastors, where we gather burning questions from cells, zones, on the transition of SIBKL. I'm your host, Pastor Sean. I've been here in SIBKL since 2001. I'm the youth pastor, and I've been a member of SIBKL for a long time. But today, I'm continuing this conversation we're having with our senior pastors, our incoming senior pastors. But today, my guest here today is our incoming senior pastor for our main church, Pastor Isaac Ling. July 7th,
yeah.
He would be, Pastor Lee Chu would be transiting to Pastor Isaac. Yeah. Pastor Isaac would be the senior pastor of main church.
Wow. Okay, there we go.
How does that sound? Do you feel like...
I feel very weird saying it.
Yeah?
It's odd.
Has anyone prematurely called you SP yet?
No.
ESP?
Oh, no. No, no, right? No. No, I would reprimand, right? Rebuke. No.
Yeah.
It's really odd.
How does that feel?
It feels weird. It really feels weird. It has not sunk in.
It has not sunk in.
Because like for the last umpteenth years, Pastor Chu is the SP, you know? Well, Pastor Lee Chu is the SP, you know?
Yeah.
Founding pastors, you know? So it's very weird to transit. I'm not used to it. I don't know when I'll get used to it. I don't know if I ever will be used to it, but it is what it is.
Yeah. We have a running joke that you're now pill.
Yeah.
And you'll eventually be spill. But
you gotta explain to everybody what pill is.
Pill is Pastor Isaac Ling.
Yeah.
Spill is senior Pastor Isaac Ling.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
So we're gonna start our segment. Spill the beans.
Oh dude!
Yeah.
Into SP things.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So, I mean, this is what this whole podcast is about. Getting to know you as, of course, future SP. Yeah. But before we get into that, which I love that, I think let's just get to know you a little bit.
Yes.
You as Isaac Ling. Okay. Not even Pastor Isaac Ling.
Okay.
Okay, you're Isaac Ling. What does Isaac Ling do to unwind? What do you do to unwind? You're a busy man.
Yes. You really want to know?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
I think everyone wants to know, like, because you are a busy man.
Yeah, to unwind. Not so often, I must admit, but when I really need to unwind, because it's been a long, stressful period, I honestly put on my headphones.
Yeah.
And I clean the house.
Clean the house?
Yeah, man.
Pastor Kim?
Yeah, true.
She Facts. Needs fact check.
Facts.
No way. But I know you're really into chess.
I used to be really into chess.
Okay.
Like in high school, I love chess, mainly for the strategy of it and the foresight of planning.
So you like strat?
I love strat. I could just go into strat.
Are you an action guy?
Like action movies?
Yeah. Maybe?
Like as in go-getter, go outside and do stuff?
Yeah.
Not really. I'm like a geek guy. Put me in a room with a strat. I will strat over anything.
Okay.
From computer games all the way to the economy of the country. Yeah, strat, man.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I think, yeah, that's a whole other podcast.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. I think we can go into a whole podcast about strat and what you geek about. Maybe when we start Spill the Beans.
Yeah, maybe. but you know, like what the geekiest moment that I've ever strat is, I imagine that there is a multiverse. Which I don't believe in it, but I imagine there is. And then I go, okay, what would life look like for me if I went in a totally different trajectory? Whether worse or good, you know? Like, how would my life end up? Do you want to hear the conclusion?
Yeah.
My conclusion is, if I weren't a Christian and if God never saved me when I was like in my 20s, I'm not too sure if I'll be around. I'm not too sure if I'll be like even a good guy.
Yeah.
Like, you don't want to know me. I don't think you want to know me. Yeah. Fair. I don't think anybody would know me.
That is episode 2 of Spill the Beans.
Yeah, episode 2 of Spill the Beans.
Yeah.
How far down the
road? If I wasn't a pastor, I would be selling Maggi goreng, bro. Because I cook up the most busting Maggi goreng ever.
Really?
Yeah.
Then you would love Indonesia. Do you know when I would visit Surabaya, I discovered there's like 50 flavors of Indomie. So it's so cool. There's like cheese Indomie, there's
Okay. Mm. Yeah. Episode 3 of Spill the Beans. The 15 flavors. Oh, yeah.
It's unique. I like it.
Yeah. But today, I think, thank you for that. Mm-hmm. That's who Isaac Ling is.
Yeah.
But of course, it's called Hot Seat. Mm-hmm. We're meant to kind of grill you a little bit.
Okay.
Or I'm meant to kind of grill you a little bit. Talk about pressure, because you're one man going through this pressure, right?
Yeah.
But of course, you've got a family.
Yeah.
That experiences the pressure with you.
Yeah.
I think you mentioned this before, even on pulpit, that your kids are fairly young. So
yeah.
I don't think they super understand what's going on.
Yeah.
How old Mac and Jay, how old?
3 and 5, going for 6.
Okay, yeah. Probably have no idea what's going on, right?
No clue.
But of course, your wife.
Yeah.
How is she feeling that? I mean, when you pressurize someone, you kind of spill. I'm sure she's feeling a bit of that secondhand pressure. Or is she feeling that pressure as well?
I think her journey is to even step into pastorship.
Mm.
And if I can speak for my wife, what she went through is, you see, what we struggled with is, when should she be a pastor? Because if she stepped into pastorship when I'm announced as SB, then does it mean that she caved? Like, the wife of an SB has to be a pastor. Mm. So she's like, okay, fine, my husband's an SB, I should naturally be a pastor.
Mm.
So is she a pastor because she's caving into the pressure? Or is she a pastor because God called her to be a pastor? So I think we struggled in that space for quite a while, because we both believe she's called to be a pastor, we just weren't sure when.
Mm.
But I'll leave it to her to explain how God spoke to her on when she should be a pastor. And I really, truly believe it was a God moment. So she stepped into pastorship, and that alleviated a lot of the pressure of, a wife of an SB should be a pastor kind of thing. And it's kind of a lot more pressurizing in SIBKL, because both Pastor Chu and Pastor Li Chu are both pastors, right? So I think that's me and Kim. I think with the apex of my pressure, like, how do I know God really called me to be pastor?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell me.
Oh, wow. That's
that's huge, actually. Like,
yeah,
because
that's huge.
Before you get into the answer, you've always mentioned you actually didn't think about being SB.
Right. That's so true.
You
never in my wildest dreams.
Yeah.
Because truth be told, I stepped into SIBKL with, of course, both of them being SB.
Yeah.
Also kind of knowing that transition will happen, just don't know when at that time. So as a member, I already knew I will be serving under Pastor Chu, Pastor Li Chu, but yet another SB eventually.
Yeah.
Then I stepped into office knowing full well that there was a potential SB in store. So I kind of knew that even if I were to be a pastor, I would never be senior pastor, because the transition was already in place. And of course, it didn't work out at that time, but transition was in place. So never in my wildest dreams did I ever wanted to be SP. I think I had a real struggle with God for 3 years, 3 solid years. Maybe 2019 to early 2023 or middle 2023, around that time, three plus years. And I think my main struggle is, God, if you called me, sure, here I am, I'm your servant, use me however you want to use me. But if you didn't call me and I'm not supposed to be, then please remove it from me, because I don't need it. I want to serve you where you have called me to serve you. I want to be used by you in my calling and in my destiny.
Yeah.
And not everybody's destiny is to be SP, right?
Of course.
So I think that has been my prayer for the longest of time. For 3 years plus, and can I admit something? As even I'm a pastor, I can admit it, right?
Of course.
even in my humanness of prayers, in my humanness of prayers, I even prayed, God, pick anyone else. And I was praying for like people to be like, you be it, you know? I was praying like, God, I think it's him, I think it's him, I think it's her, I think it's her. Mm. I think it's her, right? I was like, yeah, man, her. I was like, why not? You know, God, I think it's a great idea. Like, I would support that idea, no problem, right? So I think that was it was a real struggle, and I think through this experience, I really learned what it means to struggle with God, to wrestle with God. Mm. And I was reading Jacob all over again. I was reading David all over again. Mm. All the stories from the Torah. And to be real honest with you, what confirmed me is three things, but I'll tell you two.
Okay.
I'll tell you
I was going to get into that question.
Yeah.
3 years struggle. Why are you so sure now?
So at the end of 2020, well, at least in the whole year of 2023, I asked God for signs, like every human do, or at least if you don't give me signs, God, I want to walk by faith and at least give me confirmation that it is it. So I think the first one, I think I've never told this story. I think the first one is through my wife. And I told God, you have to convince her more than me, because I think to some extent, it will be tougher on her than it is on me.
Yeah.
Because yes, I shoulder the responsibility, I shoulder the burden, I shoulder the leadership, I shoulder the pastoral, how the office and everything, yes. But to a lot of extent, I can't do what I do if I have to father my kids.
Yeah.
So she's there for the kids, you know. So truth be told, you know, she looks after the kids every morning and she lets me sleep in. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Kim.
Thank you, Kim. Thank you. And she, both, right? And she makes sure that they're enrolled in school, they have their school books, and they have their snacks in school, and she does the grocery, and she makes sure that they're alive. So she does all that. And I know that that job is a thankless job.
Yeah.
You know? So even though, and a lot of the times I'm on the spotlight, and she's not, and I kind of need her to be secure that we are called for this. I want her to also hear from God that I'm called for this, because it's not just a me thing, it's a we thing. So I told God that I really need you to convince Kim, like without a shadow of a doubt, please speak to her, even though I'm not convinced myself at that point, but please speak to her more than speak to me, because if she's confident, I think that's half my battle won.
Yeah.
You know, if she supports me, that's like 75% of my battles won. So I was praying, give me the confirmation, give her the confirmation. And it was one day where we were driving to church. It was along this road, this highway. And we were driving to church and she just turned to me and she told me a long story to which I can't remember.
That's just the truth. That's the confirmation from God.
I can't remember the story because I only remember the conclusion.
Okay, fair.
I only remember, I think the conclusion stuck with me. I think I need to ask him about that story. But she said that she had a dream and she had a vision. And God gave it to her after praying. And I think it was after 40 days, I think. And God gave her that dream. And in that dream, something happened. We will bring Kim back and talk about it.
Yeah.
But she said in the future, she knew it was the future event and we were both sitting and deliberating an event as SBs. Well, at least I was SB.
Yeah.
And it was a difficult time for the both of us. And I remember,
here comes the waterworks.
I know.
Go for it.
I'm definitely a crier.
Yeah.
But I always attribute it to the Holy Spirit. And I remember sitting there in the car. I wanted to stop the car. I remember sitting going, wow, God spoke to you about that. And I remember at the same time, God spoke to me. And it was at a prayer altar.
And every prayer altar I go, I would pray. Every church service, every altar, every personal altar, it would be the same question. God, if it's not for me, please. If your presence don't go before me, please. Please, I don't want to go from here.
Yeah.
If your presence go before me, how would I know that your presence will go before me?
Mm.
And when she said that, something in my heart knew that God has spoken to her.
Mm.
So even though I'm very hazy about what she said, all I remember was in that moment, the spirit was strong and my heart was pounding and it was a fluttering that I remember, like me receiving Jesus for the first time. It was that kind of experience. And I remember telling God, wow. Half of me was praying it would never come to pass, but half of me went, okay, it has come to pass. Mm. And at the same time, in that span of a week, I remember God speaking to me as well at the altar saying, son, oh gosh. Actually, I've never told this story to anyone. I told God, I'm inadequate. If you knew who I was, I wouldn't pick me. Nobody would have picked me on earth. Mm. Why me? Oh God, I'm gonna have to pause a little bit. I'm unequipped. I'm inadequate. I would not have picked me. I don't think anyone would pick me. So why me? And I remember God just saying, because I picked you. And that should be good enough for you.
Mm.
And I remember saying, but what if I fail? Or what if I don't do good enough? Or what if I don't know what I'm doing? I didn't think this interview would go this way. And I remember God saying, but you prayed the prayer. You prayed the Exodus 33 prayer. You said, if your presence don't go before me, don't take me up from here. But if you want me to go, then show me a sign. And then I said, so what is the sign? You gave Moses a sign. What is the sign? And then he said, isn't me assuring you the sign?
Mm.
And I think from Leaders Advance 2033 onwards, I've kind of been at peace at it. So I think if you knew me in 2023, it was a mad struggle. It was a mad wrestle because time is running short. But the moment God spoke to me, the moment God spoke to my wife, from then on, I think we were both at peace. And from then on, I think I've accepted it. It's still very weird for me to say, I will be SB.
Yep.
I'm not used to it. I don't feel like saying it. I've not gotten there yet, but I think I've accepted it. Not because I think I can do the job. I'm at peace because I know God's presence is with me. That even if I made a mistake, it would not be a mistake too big that God cannot fix.
Yeah.
Because His presence is with me. And that assurance is enough for me to sleep well at night and to be at peace. And maybe a sub point would be, one of my sub prayers was, God, how do I know I'm taking this job or this position or this office with a pure and clean and contrite heart?
Yep.
How do I know I'm not taking this because of the ego of men, or the pride of men, or the glory of the spotlight or the platform that SIBKL has? How do I know this is not a flesh thing? How do I know this is a heart thing? How do I know that my heart is humbled, contrite, broken, and pure before you, God? And it was only after Christmas 2023 that I got that answer.
Mm.
That when I took a 3-day break in Johor with my family, and in that break, and the busyness of 2023, and in that break, I asked God the same question. 2024 is coming, I need to know. Because one of my favorite verses is, search me, O Lord. Search me and try me and make sure that my heart is pure and clean. Yada, 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 right? And when I prayed that prayer in the solitude of the night, God revealed to me the Joseph story, where he unpackaged my life. And one day I will share with you the testimony of my life.
Yep.
I'm planning to share it at the conference for the first time this year. But when he shared the story of my life, and I fast forward to the last 3 years of my struggle, he said, in the last 3 years of your struggle, I asked God, why didn't you answer me at the very beginning? You would have made my...
Yeah.
I would have been at peace, and I would have done so many things. I wouldn't have, like... I would have made it... God, why did you only answer me towards the very end? And then God says, it is in the struggle. It is not for me to know your heart. It's for you to know your heart, that in that struggle, that I assure you that I've chosen you, and your heart before me is pure and clean.
Mm.
That you're not taking this out of pride or ego or position or glory seeking.
Yeah.
But your heart before me is pure. That you're willing to wrestle with me on your knees and in tears for 3 years. And then came 2024. I think I'm a little bit more at peace. Different countenance, maybe.
Yeah.
So I'm not wrestling against it anymore. Now it's more, God, where are you going?
Yeah.
Because that's where I want to follow. I don't want to lead SIBKL. I want you to lead SIBKL.
Yeah.
And I want to follow you. So I think one of my first, I don't like the word mantra. What's another good word for mantra? What's one of my first foundational quotes and beliefs as I take the office? And I guess you're the first to hear it, is I don't want to lead SIBKL. I want God to lead SIBKL, and I want to follow God.
Yeah.
And I want the whole church to follow Him with me.
Yeah. Cool. Hey, thanks for sharing. I think it's something a little bit awkward to share how God chose you.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
And I think it's, yeah. What you shared was really honest, and yeah, and everyone needs to hear how it's not just a let's just put Isaac up there, you know. Right. But
that's true.
As much as like I feel Pastor Chu, Pastor Li Chu, they struggled through the transitions, the setbacks.
Yeah.
So does the, like, everyone that gone through, like, every setback transition, like, the previous times we tried, even the successors would have gone through all of that.
Yeah.
And now you are going through that,
yeah,
that breaking, that molding, and it's a crazy journey.
Yeah.
That I would not hope on myself or anyone, because it's just so breaking.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, it is.
And I think, like, you mentioned Leaders Advance quite a bit, and I think it takes me back to 2022 Leaders Advance, where I think the leaders of the church heard it for the first time, that this is the model, this is what we're going for, 4 SPs, you will take main church.
Yeah.
And of course, naturally, when things go to the leaders, because we're very big leadership, it'll go to the whole church,
yeah,
right? And now the whole church knows that Isaac Ling will be SP. Back then in 2022, they knew, I mean, in their eyes, in a year and a half, right? And I'm sure you would have faced so much, not just pressure, but criticism, so much doubt, so much, now people would just talk and question, right?
Yeah.
Walk me through that process you had. I know you just went through a crazy thing, but tell me, because that was you wrestling with God.
Yeah.
Now you have like...
Wrestle with men?
I mean, yeah. Yeah, wrestle with men. Like, or maybe just people's, like, especially now that you've shared how even you went through that whole like, God, why? Mm. But now you have not just your own voice going against yourself,
yeah.
But now you have. I won't call them critics, because imagine if you've been in church for 30 years,
yeah.
And like Pastor Chu has been your pastor, mm-hmm. and now it kind of hands off to a guy like yeah. that's like 30 plus, almost 40 years younger than Pastor Chu. Mm-hmm. That's insane. I'm
37 years younger than Pastor Chu.
I just clocked that. Yeah, you're almost 40 years younger. And it's only reasonable to ask, or to ask the hard questions,
yeah.
right? And how did you feel in all of that? Mm.
I think it is a very real wrestle.
Yeah.
I think one of my, what I love about me being in this position, if I can say that, is I'm not parachuted in. I came from SIBKLs literally as a member,
okay.
as a visitor, as a member, as a call leader, I served in ministry, served in cell, and then rose up in the ranks of leadership,
yeah.
and then I've been through all that,
yeah.
cell leadership, zone leadership, and then, you know, staff pastorship.
Yeah.
And I can almost feel the heartbeat of the church. I was once the congregation. I'm still the congregation. I was once them. I know their sentiments. I know their heartbeats. And a lot of the times I go, there's only two types of talk, right? Either a genuine concern for the church.
Yeah.
Or really crazy, unfounded rumors that are meant to sow division
yeah.
and malice.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's just forget about that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Talk about genuine concerns. And every time people would come up to me with genuine concerns, like, will church change? Like, are you good enough?
Of course.
Can you carry the weight of the spirituality or the vision of strategic planning? Do you have the trust? I'm just summing up all the questions.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is, I actually appreciate the questions. Those were genuine.
Mm.
Because I'm asking myself the exact same question. And in that 3 years of struggle, in 2022, I asked myself the exact same question. Like, am I good enough? Is it me? What if people don't trust my leadership? Do I even trust my own leadership? And you know, I told Pastor Chu this in confidence in one of our private meetings as we were discussing transition. I told him one of my struggles is in the peak of 2020, 2021, 2022, in the COVID years,
yeah.
was when you hear of church scandals exploding,
mm-hmm.
not just nationwide, globally.
Global, yeah, of course.
So you see big names just going through scandals
yeah.
after scandals
yeah.
and how the church is reeling and rocking through this.
Yep.
And how it has caused so much problems in the church.
Yeah.
And walking through all that, now stepping into these shoes, I go, I don't want to be another statistic. I don't want to take up leadership just so that 20 years time, 30 years time, you know, scandals happens with me. So I had to come clean with Pastor Chu, and just in a nutshell, don't worry, I'm clean. I think.
Yeah.
I think. I hope. But clean bill of health, so to speak, spiritual health and everything, and
yeah.
my past and everything.
Yeah.
But what bothered me the most is what would happen to my kids. So I think I've reached a certain maturity, I think, to be able to discern if it's malicious gossip
yeah.
or it's not malicious and it's genuine concern
yeah.
by a leader. And I'm okay, I can take it. I think my wife can take it, but I'm really concerned about my kids for the future. When they grow up, they're under scrutiny, they're under the spotlight. How do they grow up with the pressure?
Yeah.
Such a big church.
Now they're just PK, but then they'll be
yeah.
SPK.
Oh, wow. Yes, that's right. That's right. By the way, PK, pastor's kid.
It's kind of bad already. Like, we already hear all the bad PK stories.
Right? I know.
Now it's SPK, you know.
I know.
As much as you are being promoted, they are being promoted.
Yeah, I know. And as I struggle through all that, do you know one thing that why God made, I had to wrestle for 3 years, okay? Is God was breaking me as a man, breaking through almost every pride.
Yeah.
But I think one thing he was breaking in me was a lot of insecurities in me because of what I went through in my 40 years of life.
Mm.
He was breaking a lot of the insecurities. So I know I appear very confident and very secure, But truth is, behind every confident, secure man is always an insecure person.
Yeah.
That's just how it is.
Yeah.
So I think God was breaking me through all the insecurities. So through all the genuine concerns and all through the malicious gossip that I had to go through was me asking myself and wrestling, who am I through all this process?
Mm.
Who is Isaac Ling? Am I going to cave or am I going to go to the next level? Who am I? What's going to happen to Isaac Ling through all this? And in my wrestle and in my brokenness, I had to come to the end of 2023 by bringing back that story.
Yeah.
As I spent time alone with God through all this, and God said to me, Isaac, I needed you to hear how people feel, whether true or untrue. I needed you to wrestle with all your insecurities, all your self-doubts, all your crazy, and believe me, you can get quite crazy in my head, because I want you to come to a point where you realize that in all truth of the matter, yeah, you can't do it. This is not something that you can do in your own strength, in your own intelligence, in your own skills, in your own talents, whatever that He has given me, that I needed to know that God is my only source of strength. He's the only source of identity in me.
Mm.
That it's not because of how good I am,
yeah,
but it's because how gracious and how good He is to me. So I think in that 3 years of breaking, which is why I bring back the Joseph story. So if I were to conclude the end part of my journey with God would be, I believe it's in the prison years of Joseph's life that God had to break such a man of God.
Yeah.
For him to realize that, the truth be told, he interpret dreams, his strategy over Egypt was not his ideas. It's all just the grace and the wisdom of God poured out in his life.
Hmm.
And I needed to go through that so that I never get it into my head that I'm so good that I've arrived as a human being.
Hmm.
So now I really appreciate the years of my struggle because I, as a man and in my flesh, I'm still always struggling against my insecurities. But then when I'm in Christ and I'm in God,
yeah,
I know I'm secured in Him. And I know He will pull me through. And it'll be good.
Yeah, it will be good.
SIBKL is in good hands, not because it's in mine.
Because
it's in His.
I've been in the church since 2001.
Okay.
Right? That's time. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You've been in church since?
08. 07, 08, 09, around there.
08, 07.
07, 08.
Okay, let's say 07. Mm. That's like
13, 17 years.
That's like 13, 17, is it? Okay, whatever it is.
I think so.
It's like how, because in the early days, especially with how Pastor Chu used to run the church and how they, their focus and how they started this spark, right?
Mm.
How are you, genuine question, going to make sure, because yes, of course this is God's church, of course God will lead, of course by the grace of God you will do well, but like how are you going to make sure that SIBKL remains SIBKL, that our DNAs stay? Because when you look back now, we are huge.
Yeah.
But when you look back, we were just so saturated in DNA.
Yeah.
We were so saturated in generations, so saturated in SSS, Sabah, Sarawak, Semenanjung, if you don't know. And spiritual, I mean, we are very spiritual now. But back then, we were just so saturated because we were a lot smaller. And that DNA carried throughout. And then you can see how the major influences in our church, in church and outside of church, they still carry that DNA wherever they go.
Mm-hmm.
But how are you, genuine question, SSB, you're going to make sure that SIBKL, as much as we remain God's church, but we remain SIBKL.
Yeah.
True to the call.
Hope you enjoyed this episode. How will Pastor Isaac maintain the DNA of SIBKL? Tune in to part 2 for the answer.